So, ever since Crash of the Titans and Mind of a Mutant released, they've created a stir of thoughts, or rather, controversy, for the Crash Bandicoot series. Even with the success of the Crash Insane trilogy, people still scream that the games aren't canon, simply because of how they feel about the aesthetics. I think what the human race's common flaw is that they let their feelings solidify how the product or any other matter is, and they always have this habit of jumping into a game expecting it to be just as good as its predecessors, or the best, although that's impossible, because ideas are always floating, which results in experiments happening, so even if it does do something that's similar, or just its predecessors but on new hardware, it could still turn out ass or nowhere near as expandable to its horizons. But anyways, yeah, a lot of people aren't the biggest fans of those games, and that's okay, but what the Crash fans should do is do what the Jak and Daxter fans do, and that's
moving on and pretending that the game doesn't exist. Now, this is just based on observation, but if you ask any Jak and Daxter fan what they think about the Jak series, they will give you varied responses about any of the entries prior to The Lost Frontier. But if you ask them anything about The Lost Frontier in particular, they all say, well, what is that? Or, that game doesn't exist, or, we don't talk about that game. They avoid discussing it. Why is that? Because they don't want to repeat themselves and rant about it 1,000 times for years because they're focusing on what they actually do like. Crash fans don't do this. Crash fans still talk about Crash of the Titans and Mind Over Mutant like they just came out yesterday. They get very angry and persistent about those games. Crash fans in general seem to be more toxic whenever they see something they don't like, and that was really shown during Insane Trilogy's development. It reminds me of how some people keep shoehorning Sonic 06 and Sonic Boom into literally any Sonic-related topic. I don't know, man. What do you think?
I honestly find it a little weird that people love these characters so much that they struggle to respect the effort or new things that they try, but because they aren't in complete control of these franchises and can't get what they want, this comes with the unfortunate backlash that the dev or publisher gets. I also feel like what a lot of people don't want to admit is what the hell actual bad game design is versus something that works, is functional, and isn't milking what the predecessors did in the series prior to its release. It's crazy, because people glorify these characters up the ass, but as soon as their precious children wants to do something else with their life, you know, to break out of their comfort zone, and they get away with it, it's interpreted as something bad when really it's all interpretation. That's all I can really say.